Amen. He's worthy. He's worthy. Say, Jesus, I love you. We love you, Lord. We're going to do a song that we did a few weeks ago. It's called God So Loved, and the song has a different vibe and a different feel to it. But I didn't want us to lose the meaning behind that, and I was seeking God for the service today, for the worship service, and here's what he gave me for this song that's God So Loved, which is based on John 3:16. It says, for God so loved the world. And my heart is that we make a worship in our praise services a personal time with him. We have our own personal time of devotion and worship. I hope you have all that with him in your private time with him. But in this time of what we call corporate praise and worship, I pray that even during this time that you would make your praise and worship personal. So where it says God so loved the world, I want you to say, God so loved Kelly. God so loved Elias. God so loved Linda. God so loved Kim, Mike, Jill. God so loved. Put your name in there right now. God so loved. One more time and believe it. God so loved. As we enter into the Easter season sooner than you think, Jesus is up on that cross with his arms open wide, and he's saying, God so loved Kelly. God so loved Chris. God so loved Scott. God so loved the world that he gave for you. Make it personal today. The song says, come all you weary, come all you thirsty. Drink of the water, this well that never runs dry. He has everything that you could ever want, everything that you could ever need. Tap into his well, into his water spring today. That's where you're going to find his goodness, his mercy, his forgiveness, his might, his strength, and his power. He came for all of us. We're all sinners. There's not one person here that hasn't committed sin. We ask for forgiveness every single day for our sin. And it's only because of the blood of Jesus that we are forgiven and we are set free. The verse that really stuck out to me this time is, bring all your failures, bring your addictions, come lay them down at the foot of the cross. Don't carry it with you. I know I might sound like a broken record sometimes up here, but it's just such a big message. I think we carry things around for too long. The devil beats us down with our problems for too long, for not just days and weeks and months, but for years sometimes. It's time today, right now, to lay it down, let it go, let God help you through it. Lay it down, leave it here, so that he can propel you into the next thing that he has for you. He has purposes. He has plans. Don't let things get in your way of that happening. Look at your heart today. Explore inside in your heart today. What's in the way of moving on in God? That's the good news today. We have good news in him, that God so loved the world that he gave for each one of us. You can come forward at any given time during praise and worship to do your business with God. You can do it at your chair where you're standing. But please, just deal with you and Jesus today, whatever it is, and know that God loves you.
is waiting. God so loved the world.
Jesus, Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
God, you're so good. God, you're so good. God, you're so good. You're so good to me.
Sing it again, church.
God, you're so suffering, Lord, I will.
Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
Take it all, take it all, my life in your hands. My heart is yours, my heart is yours. Take it all, take it all, my life in
your
hands. You can take it all, take it all. Take it all.
As we were coming to the conclusion of our worship, the Lord just showed me a picture of a garage. And as we're singing, "My heart is yours," the Holy Spirit just showed me a garage full of clutter, full of messes to the point where you couldn't even use the garage what it was for anymore. You couldn't fit a car in there. You couldn't do any work in there. And that picture just spoke to me of how our hearts get cluttered with so many things. By us saying, Lord, my heart is yours, basically we're saying, Holy Spirit, clear out the clutter. You decide what's useful and what's not. The Lord needs to pull a big dumpster up sometimes. And we need to just stand back and let him toss out what he says isn't useful. Oh, we want to cling to our clutter. Say, oh, no, I need this. Lord, my heart is yours. Take out of it everything that you deem unnecessary. Unclutter my heart so that it's full of the things that are useful for your kingdom, for my growth, and that I would function in a way that would bring pleasure to you. I ask all this in Jesus' name. For my brothers and sisters here today, Lord, we ask you to unclutter us. Let's just give them a hand clap of praise today.